Hi. It's been a while that I've done a Facebook Live video, and a lot of people I've been connecting with lately are asking me, hey, what's it like to take our business that is currently in energy and nutrition, in relationships, in connection, in creating healthier cities, in bringing students together, in what if we're doing what we're doing in wellness right now in a large organization or a corporation? How does this job look like? What exactly do you do? Many people ask me, isn't this just a workshop that we do? How can we get lasting effects of the wellness work we are doing in a large organization? And is it fun? How is it to do this for like not even the biggest corporations, but how is it like to work in the corporate wellness? And I notice a lot of people I talk to are a bit like, oh, corporate, how is it gonna go? And do I have to wear a black suit every day? No, you don't. It's actually the opposite. It's actually really cool. I didn't really know this job existed until 5 years ago when I wanted to take my marketing and communication skills, my coaching skills, motivating people, training people, and yeah, do this in large organizations because I was fascinated about having like 200 people together, thousands of people together. How can you be a health coach? How can you coach people, but not doing it one-on-one, but bringing a whole organization in the same energy vibration for a same goal, and that goal is let's be healthier all together. So when people ask me, what does a corporate wellness job look like? Don't just think about corporate, think about any organization that brings people together. It could be a city, it could be a university, it could be a company, it could be a club of all people surfing together already who want to work on healthy food habits. It's just people together already. And yeah, there's one major ingredient, and that's asking what people want, what they need, and what they want. Who wants to don't just put it out there. It's just like if you go to a company, don't just go there and put on all these things about nutrition or healthy food or sleep. Many people are like, oh, just let us work, please. But when it becomes really cool, this corporate wellness job, if there's really like a need in an organization, like many people are tired or in burnout or lots of stress because of digitalization, and if you come in an organization at that point where really everyone feels like we need a little bit of support, and then you can really pinpoint like, okay, a lot of people in this organization are getting in disease. How can we shift it? How can we bring up our own energy? And a corporate wellness job always starts talking to management or the leaders of an organization, the founders who put their vision and mission out there, and to see how people, as the most important part of an organization, can contribute to that. So we always do it in 6 steps, a corporate wellness setup, the setup of an organization that is focused on being more and more self-steering because initiatives need to come from the people. There's a beautiful quote, everyone wants change, but no one wants to change. And you see it a lot in companies that put a fitness and then it's not being used because something in the brain needs to shift. And it can shift really easily when everyone knows how the brain works. So as a corporate wellness consultant or manager, the biggest key is to learn how the brain works, how behavior can be changed. And how this job looks like as you start talking to management, hey, what's happening? Oh, many people are leaving. Why are people leaving? Many people are in dis-ease. Why are they in dis-ease? And in this job of combining the corporate organization part with the wellness, you go in a second phase, and once you know, like, we don't want this anymore. We don't want 15% of the people to be in disease. Usually society solves it, but sometimes society comes a little bit later, and organizations take a first drive to already help everyone in the company find some ease. And then a second step is to just talk to everyone. What's happening? What's changing that 5 years ago we had disease of 5% and now we have disease of 15%? What changed? and then have a look at the human body and natural states of working, of flowing, of being healthy. And in a second phase, if you have this job of corporate wellness, you really go and talk to everyone and just say, look, how does your job look like? When do you have brain space? When do you take a rest? When do you meditate? How many new things a day do you learn? How does your food look like? How does your sleep look like? And you really just start talking to people and asking, look, how's it going? How are you working? And once you've made it really clear, because companies, they have, it's really beautiful, like these large organizations, it's a law of attraction. So people who work together in an organization or in a city or in a company, they all have kind of the same similar beliefs, because that's why you like it there, because that's why you joined. So it's really cool as a corporate wellness consultant to go and check out what are the beliefs, how are people behaving? Are people showing up for meetings? Is everyone always late? Because if everyone's always late, then everyone always goes home late. How are decisions made? Are they made instantly and does it create peace of mind? Or are decisions, does it take months and is it all blurry? And does it create a bit of fatigue, of the indecisiveness? And as a corporate wellness consultant, you're like an external person having a look like, wow, all these beautiful people who came together for a reason, for a common cause. And now some things aren't working and you can change a couple of beliefs, very simple. And you go talk to the people like, what serves and what did you do different 5 or 10 years ago? What do you need? Maybe more brain space is needed during the day, every 2 hours, a 10 minute to just let all these new processes sink in. So the job, and that's what this video today is about. And thank you everyone for watching. If you have any questions, bump them in. So if you want to become, I've had the question a couple of times of people who say, how will this job look like? I think I want to do it, but how would it look like? And I just jumped in 5 years ago and I created the job. I read this quote and it said, in the future, every job will be created. And isn't that awesome? When I was building a team 2 years ago, I would loved if everyone just came and said, this is what we're doing today. This is what we're doing today. And it just makes it a lot easier. It's crucial to have a very, very good mission, financial goals, strategic goals, to have this going. So in a third step, when we do a corporate wellness project, some boundaries are created. If people say, yeah, we need more brain space during the day. Well, yeah, is it okay to work 4 hours and meditate 4 hours? I'm not sure. We'll have to see how that affects the results. And as a corporate wellness consultant, you're a constant in between what is good for the company, what is good for the people, because both are needed. You can't just meditate 8 hours a day because no work will be done. But you can't just work 15 hours a day for 7 days a week, because then on the short term, yeah, there's going to be more output, but on the long term, customers will feel it. So what happens next in a fourth step is action. Action is the only thing that will get real results. And action comes when everything is aligned. So once it's clear in a company, in a city, in a university, what is needed? How is this culture? What kind of little mindset things do we need to change? People get into action and you'll see it. It's called inspired action. If everything is clear and everyone's involved and everyone feels well and everyone is working together, for example, to eat healthier, to measure how the body can be less acid, because acid has to do with inflammation. And if you feel in your body, for example, your belly is always hurting, you can eat more alkaline, for example. And if all your colleagues are working on it, it's just a lot easier than doing it yourself or after work. So in a fourth step as a corporate wellness consultant, you're going to look for that 80%. Because if 80% of the people are taking action and posting pictures of their new healthy food, being creative, it means the brains are changing. It means everyone is taking action and changing behavior. And I love it. And for me, it was like in the beginning, you kind of like duplicate yourself, you know, because when you're a coach, you can work with one person or two or three or 10 or 20, but there's real patterns. People have the same kind of ways of learning. And then some people, the first day they share a picture, some people the next week. But when you get to that part where, you know, you've made all the puzzles and you know this organization is really ready to change and change the culture, and you just see boom, boom, picture after picture, people enjoying playing with their colleagues to create a healthy culture together. my goodness, it's just a good feeling. And you're actually, you don't have to work anymore. You're just like, oh, it's happening, it's happening, it's happening. Because you've set the alignment, and people who are working in yoga space and in tantra space and in energy space will know the action. You don't need to push anyone to do it. People will do it if they're inspired. And as a corporate wellness consultant, it's your job to look, okay, is everyone aligned? Is everyone feeling it? Is it authentic? Are we really sharing what it's about? Because it's about organizational results always. Because that's the purpose, and that's why people were hired. But in step five, we then look at that 80% of the people that started doing new things, started eating healthy. You want to make sure it lasts on the long term. So when a new brain pathway is created, so let's say I used to eat like a waffle every day at 10 a.m. And now because of this project, every time with my neighbor or in my company, I don't eat a waffle anymore, but we make chocolate mousse. Oh my God, I love it, with avocado and chocolate and dates. It's so good. And now I don't eat that waffle, but I eat this and I take a picture, and then my roomie makes it better, or my colleague makes it better with some goji berries on it. Even better. Then a picture goes and the whole company knows, and before you know, you're building a food company from an IT or a tech company. But And the fifth part, you can start forgetting about it. So the next part is these brain pathways. If you always do the waffle and now you're doing a chocolate mousse, then it's important as a corporate wellness consultant to make sure there's a community. It's only working if it's community based. Because if people support you, if you forget after a couple of weeks, like, it's too much work, always buying the avocado and the chocolate mousse, and I can't do it anymore, let's just take that waffle. Then if there's someone in a company like, hey, I want to help, you know what, I'll make it for you, someone can make it, we can automate it, kind of making a startup in a company. And if you have colleagues who have the same issue, this is the way for like long-term behavior change, because these brain pathways, and I've drawn some pictures, I've written a book about this, because it's been such a big study also for me. I've changed this whole thing here. I wish I had a picture 3 years ago of my brain and now. It's been confusing, but it's changed a lot, the way I think. So if you make a new brain pathway, it's small. So it's easy to go back to the big highways that were there for 20, 30, 50, 70 years. So if you make a new thing like the chocolate mousse instead of the waffle in the morning, you can easily fall back because it's more, yeah, convenient to go on the brain pathways. So in this video, welcome everyone for watching, and I didn't think many people would watch. I just thought I'm gonna do a Facebook Live again. It's been a while, because I had some questions. I'm actually sharing how the job of corporate wellness consultant looks like. So it's not just corporate, it's in cities, it's in universities, everywhere where you have a group of people of maybe at least 200, how you observe how this group has the same mindset and belief, and look at, okay, maybe there's a lot of disease happening, maybe people are leaving, what's happening? Maybe some beliefs need to be changed. And so in the first step, you really look like, what is the organization purpose? What is the number? If we have 15% of disease right now in an organization, let's bring it to 5%, and it's gonna save us €500,000. And in a second step, you're going to listen to the people and look for the beliefs. What are the beliefs that aren't serving anymore right now? And you're going to ask people who have healthy habits, the people who've been in a company or organization for 30, 40 years, working from their heart. They know why they're there. And you're going to look for those examples, those ambassadors who already have healthy habits, who love a healthy chocolate mousse, who love to move during the day. I've met some amazing people last week who work from their van in Belgium. It's beautiful. I've seen people in companies who come with these little carts, and there's so many examples everywhere, and they all say the same thing. Yeah, I'm the weirdo. So if you want to change a culture, you need to bring those little mini intrapreneurs in the company and put them on the foreground. So in the 6 parts, and where we train this methodology to people to become corporate wellness consultant, after you set the goal, after you find these ambassadors, you bring a structure in the company so everyone gets along, so there's people walking through the company, actually helping you. Like, look, I'll be walking around and in my team a couple of years ago. It was awesome because I had a corporate wellness manager myself. I didn't have to play that role. And then they would be like, hey, look, we're going to eat some healthy pie tomorrow afternoon. You can come. It's only 5 minutes. And then you can do that meeting. And they kind of help you, like, bring it in your schedule. It's like, damn, this is awesome. And so in a fourth step, 80%, can you imagine 80% of 200 or thousands of people, they're all changing their behavior and sharing it with each other. Look, I made a healthy pie. Look, I'm walking during a meeting. I'm going home an hour earlier. I'm bringing my dog to work. I mean, all these ways of finding this natural flow of work, which isn't that strict anymore, but which has amazing results. And then bring it on the long term, which is part five. Make sure it stays alive on the long term. Community, supporting. Imagine during the day you want to go swimming and your company makes a route to the swimming pool. They even reserve a locker for you that you just have to jump in your locker. And how amazing wouldn't that feel? And this actually brings a lot of business result for companies. And in a sixth step in this methodology, we use as corporate wellness consultants. We're about 7 people now. That are being trained, Belgium, Netherlands, Canada, Australia. We evaluate the results, like, okay, how does this business do this year? How is the turnover? How many people are in disease right now? And it's beautiful. You can actually see a change. And even after a day, like if you really work with the mindset change, you see things change so quick and action comes. So if you get 80% of the people along, this is inspired action and people have actually changed behavior. And right now a lot is happening after work, outside of work. And I know a lot of wellness professionals tell me, yeah, but we spend most of our time at work. It brings in the money, financial income too. So it's such an important part of our lives. What if every company would be a retreat center? I mean, you just walk in, I need a massage right now. I've been traveling the world now for 2 years to get inspired. Like, I'm living right now in a little bit of my own mini retreat center. I found this in Portugal. It's been my dream. I have my yoga shala. I do meetings when I'm doing yoga. So I put my phone on. I have my calls when I'm coaching and I can do some yoga. I have a walking meeting here. I still have to figure this one out because I was hunted by 2 wild dogs. Not wild. Dogs yesterday. So, I mean, would be easier to have this in a company. There's an outdoor working space where you can work. There's actually a dance space. It's really cool. Ecstatic dance is such a big thing because it's so healing. So I recommend every company to start doing ecstatic dancing. So there's like this little platform behind where we can do some ecstatic dancing. And it's been my mission now for 2 years, and I wrote a book about being a digital nomad, of finding the coolest office environments with all these little corners. This is the meditation corner, where during the day, if I've had a lot of new brain pathways, I can meditate. But just having these corners, and I mean, I'm the ambassador in this kind of little, my little queendom here for a couple of weeks. But this could be every company, and it will boost productivity. And the more freedom, the more responsibility, of course. Because what I've learned from 2 years as a digital nomad, I mean, you're surfing and then, oh my God, I have a meeting. You really need to be really strict and get new habits to make sure you still get all the work done on time, in a professional way, find Wi-Fi or 4G. But it's amazing because it's a natural flow. I sometimes work all through the night and then the next day I go surfing. And every company can actually do this. So that was it, actually. And I see Yala has a question. How do you change the spirit of the organization instead of make people do new things for a few weeks and return to the old habits? Changing the spirit of an organization is actually culture change. So I talked a little bit before about the 80%. An organization is a group of people, and everyone started in the organization for a similar purpose. Or a similar, something attracted them with everyone they met, they connected. So they were on the same vibration. Now, changing the spirit of the organization, it's a group thing. It's about making sure people have similar beliefs. And Yeah, instead of doing new things, I see that all the time. Like, we're gonna do a week and we're gonna do a week of soccer, and then it stops, right? So you don't want to just do a week of soccer. You want to ask, hey, in our company, do we have over 10% of the people who want to do soccer, and then do soccer together every week, do little tournaments, find each other in this area. So you want to, I call this a move, and we call this a move. It's a model we created with a company, and making sure it lasts on the long term starts with people asking for it themselves. So we usually just ask everyone in a company, what do you want? How do you want to work healthy? You give a little bit of inspiration, like, would you like to do yoga during your meeting? Would you like to do something else? So new things, of course, can come in, but then they need to become a habit. People need to commit, like, I'm gonna keep doing this for a couple of weeks or months. And a corporate wellness manager, which is a real job in a company, helps the people to come together to make sure if they need anything. The moment you need things and you don't have a solution or time for it, it stops. So, for example, we had it once and people wanted to do padel or table tennis. But then where do we go? What materials do we need? How is the insurance? This all needs to be done by the company, because if you have to organize it all yourself, it's a full-time job. So how to change the spirit of the organization? Number one, ask people, what do you want? What do you need? I mean, you can do all these stop smoking campaigns, but do you really want to stop smoking? If people don't want to stop smoking, if they don't really understand why, what's the dynamics behind why do I smoke, what's my cue for smoking, there's not really the point. So ask in a company, like, look, if we have a lot of people leaving, why are we leaving? How come this company we applied with so much motivation, we now want to leave? Or if a lot of people are in disease, what's actually, I mean, work pressure, what does it mean, work pressure? Is it the meetings? Is it the goals? Is it not having time? Is it helping each other? What exactly is happening? And if that is clear and small initiatives can be taken, then it can be changed. And you need 3 to 6 months to make these new brain pathways. And as everyone is doing it together, it strengthens each other because you're in the same energy. And then it stays on the long term. And the only thing to change the spirit of the organization is let everyone understand how you can change your own behavior. How thoughts become emotions, become actions, become behavior. So, yeah. Wow, I just jumped in this Facebook Live and I love to answer these questions. But, yeah, let me know, Yala, if this answers your question or if it raises new insights or questions. And I'm happy to answer them right now or to do it later. Actually, I can actually bring you on camera. That would be so cool. Because sometimes it's hard to interpret the words, right? Like, what does a word mean? Let me see, Yala, if I can bring you on camera. No, I don't see the camera. Benedict, I can bring you on camera if you have a question. Olivier, Michael, Michael, I can bring you guys on camera. But sorry, Yala, I can't. I think it's about the phone. So, yeah, if you have any questions about this, I made this video because I have a lot of people from the wellness space asking me, like, what does it look like to be a corporate wellness consultant? Like, I don't want to work in a suit in a company and I don't want to do meetings. You don't have to. A corporate wellness consultant is actually there to observe the mindset of a whole organization and to find a way to promote ambassadors in new healthy habits and create the workplace of the future together with the CEOs of these beautiful companies. So, yeah, I like interaction a lot, and this is kind of one way, but if you have any questions, feel free to ask me in a PM message, or we can do a Facebook Live together next time. So, see you all, and yeah, have an amazing day if you're at work. Make a healthy habit or move, and maybe do some yoga, or have some good, I don't know, healthy drinks at work, or take 5 minutes to just open your brain to have more space for new brain orgasms. Or maybe you're feeling really, really good and you don't need anything. Awesome. So see you next time on these Facebook Live videos. Ciao, ciao.